Yes, and how great is our God?
Amen.
Our God's great.
Yeah.
Right.
And I thank God for that. So let's give her a hand clap and give God a hand clap for praise. Sister Donna, would you want to come up here and sing now this time?
They pastor an awesome church in Columbus, Ohio. She might want to share a little bit about how well you started. I'm scared of you, Jeep, that one. But you know what? They still let me drive them.
I know one thing for sure. I don't ever want to go through that again.
Amen.
I mean, I worked in nursing homes practically all my adult life. I've seen people come, I've seen them go, I've seen God take people, I've watched them die. Yes. But when it's somebody close to you, it's a whole different story.
Yes.
And not to rattle on about it, but when we got out, when we stopped in her driveway, she said a couple words and then she was out. She was just out. So I got out of my side, I was on the passenger side. I got out the door, went over there and checked on her. She wasn't breathing. And I took her pulse and stuff. And she started turning all different colors. And I told Peggy, which is our other friend, I said, she's gone. Her eyes were starting to roll back in her head. And she was totally dead weight. And there's no way in this side of heaven that Peggy and I could lift this woman. And I said, Peggy, I said, we got to pray. We got to get her down on the ground so we can do CPR. And I said, all we got to do is ask God to give us the strength. And I said, in the name of Jesus, let this woman come out of this car.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Yes.
Let me tell you something. I don't know how she got there, but she got out on the floor. Praise God. And so we started doing CPR, and we had to wait till the whichever got there first. And so we kept her, you know, and then when they come, they took over. They stripped her right there on the sidewalk. But praise God, she's here today.
Yes.
God's still miracle worker.
Yes.
Praise the Lord, he's still a healer, a deliverer. Hallelujah, glory to God. He's a God of all gods. Can you say that? He's no other God before him. Praise God. I love him today, don't you?
Yes.
Hallelujah. I don't want to take up too much time. Hallelujah. But all time belongs to God anyway.
That's right.
Praise the Lord. I'm going to try this song. Pray that God gives me the words.
Bless you, God.
Life is easy when you're among the mountains and you've got peace of mind like you've never known.
Oh yeah, come on now.
But then things change.
Oh yeah.
Down the valley, dawn's fading. Oh, the God of the mountains, He's still God of the valley. When things are rough, everybody's around. He's the God of the mountains. Thank you.
Thank you, sister. Enjoyed that. That's great. God is great to us all the time.
Yes.
He's been great to me when I was on the mountain, when I was on the back.
Yes,
he is always there with me, and I thank God for it. At this time of this service right now, we're going to ask Sister Joe Sorkin to come around and preach for us at this time. Because this is an important part of the service. God's word.
Come on, prophetess.
Praise the Lord. Come on, let's give him praise in this house.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. So let's give him praise.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Give God some praise. Because
yeah.
He wanted to be praised. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. One that's called power in heaven and earth. Amen. Praise God. He's looking for those that's going to worship him in spirit and truth. He said, I seek such. I seek the true worshipers of God. How many true worshipers of God we got in here? Hallelujah. That's going to move by the spirit of God. Hallelujah. The Bible said he spoke the word. And he moved upon it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, what no light, come on, what nothing, it was void, it was darkness, but it sprung, let there be light, and there was light, hallelujah, light, come in a dark time, I don't know about you, but God is able, I said God is able to bring his people out, somebody said the church is dead, ain't no power. Somebody said he's a now God. He's a God that's going to move for his people. Hallelujah. I can feel a shifting in the spirit of God. I feel a shifting in the church. Hallelujah. I don't believe it's just going to be just an ordinary time. I believe that God's going to move again. Hallelujah. He's always moved. But God wants you to move. Somebody say amen. He wants you to move. He wants you to hear the word of life. Know of the power. Hallelujah. Know of the life. It's in Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. If you have your Bibles, turn with me to 1 Samuel. I don't know if I can even add to. Praise the Lord. That was enough word there. Amen. To resurrect us. Come on. Hallelujah. But God is good. And I don't take much time. I'm just going to give what God said. Amen. And go on. Amen. Hallelujah. But if you have your Bibles, turn to 1 Samuel chapter 30. Praise the Lord. And it came to pass and one, and when David and his men were come to Ziklag, that on the third day that the Amalekites had invaded the south, and Ziklag had smitten Ziklag and burned it with fire, and had taken the women captives, and that were therein, and they slew not any, neither great or small, but carried them away, and went on their way. And so David and his men came to the city, and behold, it was burned with fire, and the wives and the sons and the daughters were taken captive. But then David and the people that were with him lifted up their voice and wept until they had no full power to weep. Oh God, I thank you, Jesus, for your word and for your truth. I thank you, Lord, for your anointed God. I thank you, Lord, for fresh oil from the glory. Don't saturate us, Lord. Remove, God. Shift us, Lord. Shake us, Lord. Whatever you've got to do, but let us receive your word. Lord, destroy every yoke, God, in this place. In Jesus' name. Amen. Yes. The Bible said they had wept, they had cried till there was no more crying in them. All the people began to rise up against David, the man of God. How many times have you cried to the one nothing left? He did not cry. You tried to moan and you tried to groan. But there was so much you was going through. You've been through the storm and you've been through the rain. You've been through death and it compassed you about. The thing that they loved was taken away. You can mess with a lot of stuff, but when you take somebody's money, you better watch out. When you take somebody's hallelujah heritage, you better watch out, because that's where it gets you at. It gets you in the heart. If a man's a true man, he'll fight for his family. Ain't no weak ones in this army. God's gonna people out of the people. He's a raising up Zion. He's a raising up an army. That's gonna take it by force. The one that killed David, he was greatly distressed because his people spoke, I'm going to stone him. Oh, hallelujah. But because the soul of the people, they were grieved too, because they lost their wives too, they lost their children too, because the enemy had come in and taken their positions. Oh, how many times and the enemy come in and taken your possession. I tried to cast you out of what belonged to you. Somebody said, what are you talking about? When you're getting something close to your heart and the devil trying to take it from you, there comes a fight in the believer. Hallelujah. But David, the Bible said, he began to encourage himself in the Lord. I don't know about you, but I have to encourage myself in the Lord. How many times in my life I didn't have hallelujah, somehow mama with me, or my daddy, hallelujah, I didn't have nobody backing me, but the Holy Ghost, the anointing of prayer, it touched me, and I should be, and then my very calls, it was like Jeremiah said, it like fire.
Yes.
Hey, I said it like fire. Shut up in my bones. I understood where David was at. He lost his friend. He know what a demon was. But you wanted to stone him now. Because we was with you, David. And they come in. And they took what was ours. Hallelujah. The Bible said, David encouraged himself in the Lord. And David, he prayed. The Bible said, he told the son, he said, I pray thee. Hallelujah. The priest, he said, I pray thee. Bring me hither the ephod. Hallelujah. Alphabet. Thither the ephod to David. That priestly garment. Hallelujah. That word. That the Urim Thummim stone. When it by the woman to know the mind of God. Them stones, the Urim Thummim stone, will be lit up and will tell the knowledge of God and what to do. And God began to speak in David and cried at the Lord, saying, shall I pursue after this troop or shall I overtake him? And the Lord answered and said, pursue, for thou shalt surely overtake him and without the cover of and no stopping in God. I know the enemy trying to take some stuff that belong to you. I'm the Lord of a Hosea, but God said, you're going to only overtake them, but you're going to get all your stuff. You're going to get your wives. You're going to get your sons. You're going to get your daughters. Yes, Lord, I hear the Lord say, some of you got some lost ones. You got some lost sons and some lost daughters. And the devil said, I'm going to take them to hell. But I declare to you, I hear the Lord say, they're going to be recovered. They're going to be recovered. You're going to recover all.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Somebody say, my setback, the thing that told her was going to be your setback, was really your comeback. Come on, church. Somebody said, I looked at David and I seen all we done. I seen his mess. I seen you wanted another man's wife and put him on the front line knowing he was going to get killed. Somebody said, where you going? I'm telling you, your setback or really your comeback, and death can hold you. When you are known to the Lord, you've been pulled out of the fire. You caught it all by a brand put out of the fire. That high priest Joshua, hallelujah, in filthy garments, but had a change of raiment. Somebody said, God changed my raiment. He's changed my covering. He's changing my clothes. I'm the Lord of Hosea and said, Joshua, how do these others just stand by? But your road, hallelujah, that's going on me. I'm the branch, the root of the ground. Christ, come on.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Glory.
Boy, hallelujah. I'm going to get my stuff. Hallelujah. I'm going to recover all. Hallelujah. I'm going to pursue after what's mine. Because it's mine. And it's all mine. Somebody said, you're stingy. Yeah. When some mind ain't no devil in hell going to take what's mine. But I'm going to fight under the anointing. And I'm going to take back possession of what's mine. Because it don't belong to the enemy. The devil can't have my peace. The devil can't have your home. The devil can't have your marriage. You can stand against the enemy.
Hallelujah.
All of the very thing. I'm looking at David. I ain't looking at his Messiah. I ain't looking at the Dolce. I'm the Lord of Hosea. Because there was something different about David. Than there was a soul. A soul. The people wanted a king. They wanted that out of the flesh. But God ordained that to the spirit. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah. And I learned, hallelujah, Paul, or Saul, hallelujah, hallelujah, he was after the position, hallelujah, but David, hallelujah, he was after the passion of God's own heart. Hallelujah, he was the apple of his eye. Hallelujah, there was something David. Hallelujah, the woman looking at position. Hallelujah, he was looking at being in the very presence of the Almighty God. And all his trouble, yet in his spirit and heart, he said, even my soul, Lord. Hallelujah! Oh, hallelujah! Oh, hallelujah. Oh, my soul thirsts for unto thee, O Lord, even from the water brooks, even as the heart panteth after the water brooks, even so, Lord. Ah, Lord, I long for you. Hallelujah, I long for you, because God knows your heart.
Come on now, hallelujah.
God knows your heart, and he knew David loved you. And that's all God wants you. He wants you to love him. Love him more than houses and land. Love him more than possession of his life. Don't hold it in. Don't keep it back. And I lie to God. Don't hold it back. He wants your heart. He wants your desire. You've got to have a relationship. Ah, somebody said, I want to be married. But to be married, you've got to have a relationship. You've got to tend it. You've got to take it with care. And you've got to love the one that you're sleeping with. Can I get a witness in this house today? Ah, hallelujah. To be married to Christ is a relationship.
Yeah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Oh, Lord. His setback was really his comeback. Because God said, I've seen you. But you've asked after my heart. You've asked after me. You didn't seek that of those that was wanting to kill you. You didn't ask anybody, but you inquired of the Lord. And I'm telling you today, God wants you to inquire of him to know his will for your life. And he said, without my fail, you're going to pursue all, and you're going to recover all. Without a doubt, God's word shall not fail. And the Bible said in the 18th verse, hallelujah, on through there, oh my God, hallelujah. David smote them from the twilight in 17 even unto the evening of the next day. And they're not, there wasn't the east, came not a man of them, say 400 young men which rode upon camels, and they fled. And David recovered all that the Ammonites had carried away. And David rescued his two wives, and there was nothing lacking to them. Neither small nor great, nor son nor daughter, neither spoil or anything that had been taken, hallelujah, from them. But David recovered all because he inquired of the Lord. Your setback is really your comeback, for God will turn it on the enemy, and everything he sought to kill you, hallelujah. God said, I'm standing right now in front of death. The light has come, and it stands in front of death and says, not so, not today, not today. I'm reminded of the woman that I've been over for 18 years. Nobody could lift her and lift her up. For 18 years, she couldn't pick herself up. But the Bible said that Jesus saw her.
Come on now. Hallelujah.
What's it take? Just Jesus seeing you.
Come on. Hallelujah.
Only thing it takes is the Lord seeing you. Hallelujah. Looking upon her. And God was doing something. Hallelujah. But religion rose his head up. I guess the word of God. The Bible said, for in the beginning was the word. And the word was with God, the Word was God. There wasn't nothing that wasn't made through Him and by Him. Hallelujah. Just like John the Baptist crying out of the wilderness, eating locusts and wild honey, wrapped in camel's hair, looking like a wild man. Hallelujah. But he said, a voice, I'm like a voice crying out, prepare ye the way of the Lord and make his path straight.
Yes.
Hallelujah. There's one crying out, even in this city, under the Mosiah. There's a word being ushered in this generation. I know the past. Hallelujah. My roots, I'll never forget it. Under the Mosiah. Because I understand my root. I understand the roots is the life of the tree. Come on, church. They see if you pour blood around the tree, it will kill it. Under the Mosiah. Because life is in the blood. Somebody say amen. Hallelujah. But I understand if the root system is not right in planting, we can plant. But when you plant it in the planting of the Lord, hallelujah, you get results and fruit comes forth from that you planted. But the root, that's why he said, I am the root out of dry ground. You got to have the right root.
Yes, 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 yes.
For the foundation, Peter said, oh, God spoke to him. He said, who do you say that I am? He said, something, Elias, some Jeremiah, all the other prophets, but he said, who do you say that I am? He said, for thou the Christ, the Son of God, the living God. And he said, flesh and blood have not revealed this unto you, but my Father, come on, by the heaven of which is represented by the Spirit. Only by revelation you can know the goodness of God. You can say what you will, but I thank God for the revelation of my God.
Oh yes, oh yes, hallelujah.
And he said, Peter, he said, flesh and blood have not revealed this unto you. Flesh and blood. I'm showing you a kingdom. And whatever you bind in the earth will be bound in heaven. Whatever you loose is going to be loosed. God had to fulfill his word. When that woman, hallelujah, that was bent over, who was a daughter of Abraham and a daughter of faith, God had to bring his word to pass. Because the light, the man, he was more than a man. The word from glory, that the word was spoken, had to come and deliver his people. And seeing her being over, I see the church like she's been bent over, she's been crippled, but I see a Savior. I see Jesus Christ. Get ready to heal us. Get ready to bend us. You might have been broken when you come here, but how many God's healing their brokenness? How many God's men are
there?
Yeah, hallelujah. Could no wise lift herself, and religion would have kept her there because they knew the law, but they didn't understand. Hallelujah. He was the fulfillment of the law. He was the Lord of the Sabbath. You can't do that healing, Jesus. It's the Sabbath. 6 days men ought to work, but on the Sabbath day, you put to rest. They didn't understand that the Lord from glory, the Lord of Hosea, wrapped in flesh, was speaking the divine word. It was a divine appointment because God wanted to loose the children of faith, from the position they've been in. And God wanted to bring forth and show them I'm more than the law. But it's my grace is sufficient. My mercy.
Go ahead.
Oh, rewrite the pages of your life.
Come on now. Yeah. Hallelujah.
It wasn't religion that brought me out, Brother Lee.
Come on.
It wasn't some formality and some tradition.
Come on.
It was Jesus Himself. When I was lying in depression, I had a stillborn baby, held it in my hands. Death in 1996, all I seen was death. I wanted to give up. I didn't want to preach no more. I thought, God, I don't know how more holy I can get, Lord. I was doing everything I knew I could do. I thought the Lord had left me. But the Lord was there. I lay there 2 months. I wasn't eating. Every kind of forced food in my mouth, and I wouldn't eat. I was bound with depression. Anybody know what it is? I know what depression is. I've been there in the valley low.
Oh my God.
Come on
now.
Woo.
Yes,
I didn't have medicine to bring me out, church. But I'm going to tell you what I had. I had the Holy Ghost. I had some praying people. And I had Jesus that said, I called you from the foundation of the world. I called you from your mother's womb. A providence unto my people in the last days. He said, I'm going to raise you up. Get up. Get up. I didn't want to go to the bathroom. They had to drag me to the bathroom.
I didn't clean no more. I didn't want to do nothing. I was hallelujah, so bound with the demon of depression, and I was a child of God. But sometimes they happen in our life, and when the enemy gets a foothold in, he's wanting to take you, destroy you. But Jesus, the righteous, Jesus, the redeemer, Jesus, the restorer. Oh, hallelujah, he can cause a dead situation and turn it around and make life.
Yes.
He said, I'm going to restore you. Oh, God.
Amen.
He said, I'm going to restore you.
Come on.
Hallelujah. He said, get up from here and go declare a word to the state of Florida. Go to Homosassa Springs, Florida, and rent a building. I didn't know what to do. Hallelujah. I said, I gotta rent a building. He's been with Sister Joe, you gotta come. I said, God's declared a word. And he said, y'all, you're coming out. I said, God, I'm not evil. I'm down, God. He called out a Messiah. But it's in your lonely times. It's in your dark times. That you can really know he's the lily of the valley. He's the rock in the weary land. I said, why do you preach so crazy? Why you so crazy? I'm going to tell you something. I've been through hell. Hallelujah. And I survived. And I cried. Not to lay down and cry about it, but to find these are tears of joy. I know where God brought me from. I wanted to quit. He wouldn't let me quit.
Come on now. Hallelujah.
I guess y'all ain't never been there.
Come on.
You've been there.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They got me a building, renting the building for a 3-night revival. God spoke to me. I said, God, I'm not even able. His spirit told me, Lord. He said, you go preach, because I'm going to deliver you as you begin to preach. And I told him, he said, when I deliver you and you deliver that word, he's going to deliver those. He said, there's some women there. How are you not coming out of this by yourself? Grab some women. Grab some people and pull them out and pull them on through. I'm going to deliver women. I'm going to deliver them depression. I'm going to deliver them of death. I'm going to deliver them. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Preached the word of God, and I had 80 to 100 a night, and 80 come in the altars, and then women begin to cry out, and the anointed of God destroyed the yokes. He could run that little Bahia. I let help hold me up.
Because I got through praying. It wasn't nothing dry on me, brother. I was under the anointing of God. And from that day forth, God delivered me. Somebody said, has it ever tried to come back up on you? Yes, it did. When my mother died, oh God, a depression hit me. It didn't last long. I think it was about 2 days. Another husband, he said, you got to get up and you got to shake yourself and you got to preach your way through this. I thought, my God, I love my mama and I love my daddy. I understand my roots. Holiness is in me, baby. I can't help it. I ain't made to shine or religion. Holiness I got. And that's the love. And it's a perfected love that loves you beyond what you are. At this point, I'm a little higher at your setback. I love you and your comeback and your setback. Because I'm pulling you through.
Amen. Oh, yes. Hallelujah.
Yes. I'm pulling you through. Just like Joseph. I'm the Hosea. Hallelujah. A dreamer in the house. Is there a dreamer in the house? God began to speak to me. And he said, I placed you a dreamer in your house. I'm glad there's a dreamer in the house. And there's got to be a dreamer in your house. If you don't got a dream, and if you ain't got a vision, you're going to perish. I'm a dreamer. And when I dream big. Because we serve a big God that can do big things. He can take a small thing and twist that thing around and cause an explosion. Can I get a witness?
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise God. I'm getting ready to close. But Joseph, the dreamer, the love, his daddy loved him, made him the special coat. But the brothers were jealous of Joseph.
Come on.
There's going to be some people jealous of your elevation. Some of the time, I'm fighting. I don't understand what I'm fighting. Because you're called, baby. God knows you where you've been. But you was called, hallelujah, to do the work of God. And the enemy wants to stop you any way he can. Hallelujah. But he cannot defeat what God ordained.
Right. Oh my, hallelujah.
So I'm going to get Joseph. I'm going to throw him in the pit. But from the pit to the prison house to the king's house. Somebody say amen. And God took him, didn't he? Out of the pit to the king. And from there to the prison because of a woman, a wife. Hallelujah. I'm going to try to mess him up. His setback. Was really his comeback. Can I get a witness? I said his setback was really his comeback. I was down there, but they remembered Joseph, that he was a dreamer and he can interpret dreams. And the king had one. Oh my God! And there was one dreamer in the house, head of the whole shire, that could interpret it. Is there some dreamers in the house tonight? I said, is there some dreamers in the house today? Hallelujah! God wants to dream up.
Well, yes. Come on now.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Pursue. Hallelujah. For thou shalt surely overtake and without. Hallelujah. Fail. You'll recover all. I'm talking about some people. Hallelujah. That are precious in the sight of the Lord. Could not stay 18 years bound and bent over. For the life of glory, the word that was spoken. See, anytime the word brings life. Somebody say, man. In the Old Testament, the prophet would bring the horn and the oil, and how when these prophets, Samuel, come on, they got, some got scared, some got weary. Because there's two offices that the prophet brought, and that was either blessing or curse. Hallelujah. But that day when he anointed David, he was coming to bless the house of Israel. He was sending them somebody that had the heart of the God. Someone said, I don't understand. Just think about yourself. Sometimes your heart been messed up. Your life's been in troubles. You come from dark places and dark things. But even in your dark time, I'm going to see somebody. Some man or woman of God. Somebody prayed you through. Somebody called your name before glory. That power in prayer. I said that power in prayer. It's your setback, but really, it's your comeback today. Donna, your comeback was life. Your comeback was to do a work in this earth. Think about all that you've been through. He was there all the time. He was waiting patiently in line. Hallelujah. He was there all the time. Oh God, hallelujah, I will never forget. And I can keep on going on and on about experiences of my life and ministry, because God's taken my feet many places. Amen. Many things has happened in my life. I want to tell you something. He is a restorer and a recoverer of all things in your life. Hallelujah. Raise your hands. Close your eyes. Hallelujah. God, I thank you, Lord. I could go on and on. And hallelujah. And bring it out real pretty, God. Hallelujah. And God, you said, Lord, hallelujah, in Psalms 30, I will extol thee, O Lord, for thou hast lifted me up. Thou hast not made my foes to rejoice over me. O Lord, my God, I cried unto thee, and thou hast healed me. O Lord, thou hast brought up my soul from the grave. Thou hast kept me alive, that I should not go down to the pit, but sing unto the Lord, O ye saints of his, and give thanks at his remembrance of his holiness. For his anger endureth but a moment, but in his favor is life. Weeping may endure for the night, but joy cometh in the morning. And in my prosperity, I said, I shall never be moved, but Lord, by thy favor, thou hast made my mountain to stand strong. Thou didst hide thy face, and I was troubled, but I cried to thee, O Lord, and unto the Lord I made my supplication. God has heard somebody's cry. I believe your life's not going to be the same. Hallelujah. Because it was by divine appointment. Hallelujah. That we meet. Somebody say amen. That our paths cross. Hallelujah. You were ordained and called for a purpose and a reason. Hallelujah. God wants us to have the unity of the faith. And it's because of the unity of the faith. Hallelujah. For the perfecting of the saints, that we all come. Did he say? Hallelujah. In the unity of the faith. Hallelujah. Praise God. And he said, I sent some of these prophets and apostles, didn't he? Apostles and prophets. Hallelujah. And evangelists and pastors. Hallelujah. Teachers for the perfecting of the saints, that we all come by coming to the unity of the faith. God wants unity in faith. Because when there's unity, there's love. And love moves with God. And God is love. Hallelujah. He moves things for us. He's moving for you. How many believe that? Give him a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. You're sitting back. Is your comeback? Come on and praise him. So I turn this back over. Hallelujah to the bishop.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. What a word. What a word from heaven. Sister Cindy, come and lead us in a song.
My. I looked at my husband, I said, my God, I feel like I'm watching myself preach. There was things you said, there's things that I said. You know, when we come into the unity, amen, amen, it's just like there's just something, brother, that just, I don't know, it's them golden nuggets is what I like to call them, amen. How many of y'all take Jesus above everything else, amen? Hallelujah.
Oh, as they gambled for the rugby war, they chose the worldly trail, not thinking about eternity. As the soldiers drove the nails, Lord, will we learn from what they've done? Will we make the same mistake? Which one will you take? I'll take Jesus. I'll take Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, I've tried those earthly pleasures, and they fail. But when I reach the gate, I'm gonna hear the Master say, me or the world, my child, oh, which one will you take?
No matter what kind of darkness, no matter what I walk in, I always want to have Jesus on my side. Hallelujah. Even though the pages of my life have turned, I'm still gonna take Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, as the pages of my life have turned, Lord, time has rolled away. You see the greatest thing that I have done, they won't help me out on that day. When all my earthly treasures, Lord, I take them, I lay them away. There's gonna be to me just a memory. Oh, did you gonna hear me say, I'll take Jesus. I'll take Jesus. Lord, they fail, and when I reach the gates in heaven, I'm gonna hear the Master say, me or the world, my child, oh, which one will you take? Me or the world, my child, oh, which one will you take?
Give the Lord a hand clap. Stage has been set, church,
yes, it has.
For something very great tonight.
Yes.
And I'm really looking forward for a divine transfer from
Amen.
Heaven to earth.
Me too.
We pray, Lord, that kingdom come, thy will be done. We want heaven and earth to come together tonight here in this place. And I believe we're going to see some very great things happen. God's got something in store for us.
Yes.
So let's keep our minds on the Lord. And I believe we're going to see some great things happen. Anything else before we dismiss real quick? I appreciate the testimonies given, the songs that were sung. It's the prophet Estelle, great word, great word. So everyone stand to your feet. We're going to have a few things to eat here in the back before we go into the service. Our home church will be with us tonight, and we're looking forward to that. So everyone say praise the Lord.
Yes. Praise the Lord.